Hello and welcome to the Global Unique Identifier System introductory video. Today I'll be walking you through and explaining the process of creating a GUID. The learning objectives of this video include what a GUID is, how a GUID is created, and how to use the GUID tool. The Global Unique Identifier System correlates participants across studies without exposing personally identifiable information, or PII. It creates unique patient identifiers, it meets federal data privacy standards, and it protects privacy of each research participant. The GUID helps researchers share data for specific study participants over time and space. The GUID creation process begins with the researcher logging into the GUID client on their computer and entering the subject PII to the GUID server. The GUID client on the researcher's computer uses personally identifiable information to derive a series of one-way hashes which securely encrypt PII. The one-way hashes are sent off to the GUID server for reference and storage. No personally identifiable information is sent to the system. The GUID server returns a random alphanumeric number, which is the GUID identifier. If the one-way hashes match a known subject, an existing GUID will be returned. If this is a new subject, a new GUID will be created. Once the researcher has a GUID, he or she may submit data associated with this subject. No data may be submitted to the system without a GUID. Once data is in the database, a researcher may query this data. The GUID allows researchers to distinguish between unique subjects and recurrent subjects across all datasets. Finally, researchers are able to access data across studies without revealing personally identifiable information while correlating study data across different studies and uniquely sorting between distinct and redundant datasets. The PII required to generate a GUID should be taken from the subject's birth certificate. It includes the complete legal given first name of a subject at birth, if the subject has a middle name, and if so, the subject's middle name at birth, the complete legal family last name of a subject at birth, the subject's day of birth, the subject's month of birth, the subject's year of birth, the name of the city or municipality in which the subject was born, and finally, the subject's country of birth. All PII is required to generate a GUID. If any PII is missing, a pseudo-GUID will be required. There are two methods for creating a GUID. The first is using the GUID tool, which creates one GUID at a time, runs online in real time, and uses the double entry format. The next method is using a CSV upload. It creates multiple GUIDs, is run offline via CSV or comma separated value file, and is uploaded to the GUID tool. Data usage in future studies. Each BRICS disease instance has its own GUID server. GUIDs are disease specific, so a patient or subject will have a different GUID if they are participating in a different BRICS disease instance.